I was at home with my family last night when we learned that our town was one of those being put into the red zone, quarantined to battle coronavirus. We had spent Saturday evening with friends, discussing how the nursery closures were affecting our ability to work. The cracks in our normal lives have been evident for some weeks. Read more, coronavirus, Foreign Office changes travel advice after lockdown in Italy, but then a leaked draft of the decree that was signed by Italy's Prime Minister, Giuseppe Conte, made us realize things were about to get much worse. As of Sunday morning, areas that are home to 16 million people are on lockdown. Residents can return, but you cannot leave for any but the most serious reasons. We do not yet know how this will be implemented, but most likely it will involve police checkpoints on the main roads. In and around Padua, a busy university town of 250,000 people, shopping centers will be closed during weekends. Cinemas, museums, libraries, community centers, sports centers, gyms are all to be closed to the public. Events, public or private, are to be cancelled. From Monday to Friday, shop and restaurant owners need to make sure customers keep a distance of 1 meter, as per the government's orders. My next trip to London, where I travel monthly for work, is postponed indefinitely. Such a severe restriction of my freedom of movement feels disturbing, perhaps more than the thought of catching the virus itself. Trying to keep some semblance of normality, I went for a long run on Sunday morning, in preparation for the Padua Marathon, which is still scheduled for next month. I saw plenty of other joggers and walkers enjoying the sunshine, cars coming in and out of town. But behind the scenes, people are trying to make sense of what it means for them. A friend owns a small business with a factory in Vicenza, outside the red zone. He and half of his team live in Padua while the rest live in Vicenza. His task for the rest of the day was finding out whether his employees could get to work the next morning. If they cannot, he will have to shut production, potentially for weeks. He is one of thousands of small business owners in the area. The whole of northern Italy, and Veneto in particular, relies on small and medium-sized enterprises. The economic impact of the epidemic restrictions will be felt for months, if not years. Before the latest move, restaurants and bars were already bare. People were cancelling holidays. The critical tourism sector is already feeling the full force of this crisis. Venetian hotels were reporting up to 40% of customers cancelling bookings. Now that number will only rise. Read more, coronavirus, Italy confirms 133 new deaths in a day as lockdown begins. Hospitals are coping as best as they can. Padua's University Hospital, one of the largest in Italy, has hired an additional 150 staff, and spaces are being for more on this story, visit the news article link.